Hello students, today we will learn about tendons and ligaments. Tendons and ligaments are another type of connective tissue. Basically, they come under connective tissue proper. They have also got the jelly matrix. So yesterday's class we discussed about areolar adipose connective tissue, that is connective tissue proper. If you see in the previous slides, we have seen here, so this is your connective tissue proper. We are discussing right now connective tissue proper. Then in previous class we have discussed about areolar tissue, then adipose tissue. So today we will be going about and we will be reading about tendon and ligaments. So this also comes under connective tissue proper, and they also have got the jelly matrix. In case of skeletal tissue have got the solid matrix and further divided into cartilage and bone. If you see the vascular tissue, it has got the fluid matrix, and it comprises of blood and the lymph. So as we are discussing about the connective tissue proper, that is tendon and ligament, we will see the tendon and ligament, they come under connective tissue proper. It means they have got the jelly matrix. What kind of matrix we were talking about? Jelly matrix. If you see tendon, this tendon is present between the bone and the muscle. It joins bone with muscle. So BTM. Tendon joins bone with the muscle, BTM. You can learn like this. And ligament joins bone with the bone. So ligament is BLB. So this is how you can learn. So ligament is a connective tissue proper having the jelly matrix. It joins two bones together. You can see here two bones are joined together. You can see bone 1 and bone 2. And in case of tendon, you see tendon is present between the bones and the muscles. Now if you see the difference between tendons and ligament, so as I told you, the tendons, they attach bones with the muscle. So bones and muscles, they are joined by the tendon, basically. Okay, BTM or MTB, you can learn either way. Then ligament attaches bone to the bone. So bone, ligament, bone, BLB. Which one is elastic? This ligament is comparatively elastic in nature. It has got elasticity, and the tendon is solid and it is sturdy, rigid. Okay, so this one is elastic, this one is non-elastic. So you can learn few of the differences. Now next type of connective tissue we will discuss today is blood and lymph. That is the fluid connective tissue. Blood and lymph, that comes under the fluid connective tissue, because they have got the matrix, that is liquid. Fluid matrix. So blood and lymph are very important, and blood is the part of your circulatory system and lymph is the part of lymphatic system. Examination point of view, so the difference is very important, and their individual functions are also very important. Okay, so both are the circulatory mediums. Blood is the liquid medium which is present as a circulatory medium in transportation system, or we say this blood circulatory system, and lymph is the liquid medium in our lymphatic system. Now moving forward, we will discuss about the blood, its function. So you see blood, the function of blood is to transport gases, that is oxygen and carbon dioxide. These are the gases which is transported by the blood. It also transports food. It also transports some of the waste materials and hormones in the body. So all these things, oxygen, carbon dioxide, food, waste material, hormones, they all move in the blood. Because if you see the blood has various parts that we will discuss. That is, the liquid part of blood is plasma. Plasma contains RBC, red blood cell, WBC and platelets. These are the blood cells which are there in the blood. Then RBC has got the red pigment called hemoglobin. And hemoglobin has a close affinity. Affinity means likingness for oxygen. And this hemoglobin combines with oxygen. So oxygen plus hemoglobin. So how the oxygen moves? How the oxygen moves in the blood? This oxygen moves in the blood with the help of Hb, which is present on RBC. And this carbon dioxide, which is carried by the blood, which part of the blood carries carbon dioxide? Plasma. Plasma is the liquid part, and carbon dioxide is dissolved in the plasma and it moves in dissolved form. And oxygen, it has a close affinity, likingness for hemoglobin. Hemoglobin provides red color to the blood, and it also get combined with oxygen. So oxygen needs a carrier basically, and that carrier is hemoglobin. And you know, this part of the blood very important, platelets. It helps in blood clotting during injury. It prevents the excessive flow of the blood from the cut or the wound. The plasma also contains some proteins and the hormones. So this is the composition of the blood plus the functions which are associated with each part of the. Now here we can see that this is the blood. Blood has got some part that is liquid part, because it has got the liquid matrix, and then it has some blood cells. This is there. Then the liquid part is called plasma. Then blood cells are. What are the different blood cells which are present? RBC, WBC, that is red blood cell, white blood cell, and platelets. Platelets. These are the blood cells. So all these blood cells, they move in a liquid part called plasma. So this is the composition of the blood, and it has got the matrix which is liquid. So plasma is the liquid part of the blood, and all the blood cells move in the plasma. RBC is red blood cell. It is red because of a pigment color called hemoglobin. Okay, it is a protein which is present here, and hemoglobin combines readily with oxygen basically. Then WBC, that is the white blood cell, it is called the soldier of the body. It is basically responsible for maintaining the immunity of the body. And platelets is associated with the blood clotting. So this is how it happens. So now we have talked about the blood, its part and function of each part. Now moving ahead, we will see Now we will study about the another circulatory medium, that is lymph. That is the lymph. Lymph is very important circulatory medium in another system called lymphatic system. This system is basically related to the immunity of the body. Immunity means power to fight back the infections or the diseases basically. Now you see the lymph, it keeps the body cell moist, because it has plasma part. Lymph is plasma plus WBC basically. So it keeps the body tissue moist. It maintains the volume of the blood. It maintains the volume of the blood, and indirectly it maintains the blood pressure also, because it comes out of the blood capillaries. Means what is lymph? some of the plasma and some WBCs, they squeeze out of the lymph blood capillaries and they come to the tissue level. So that's why I said that it keeps the cell moist. It's like this. Like for example, this is your blood vessel, arteries, and they divide and redivide into capillaries. Capillaries join and rejoin again into the vein. So this portion is your artery part. This portion is your veins part. You know, blood vessels, different types of blood vessels you have studied, and this is your capillary part. So this is artery, this is vein, and this junction is known as capillary part. Okay, and for example, the blood which is moving here, the blood which is moving here in arteries, it comes here and it moves in the capillary part. The moment it moves in the capillary part, then the flow of the blood is very slow because capillaries are very thin. Okay, so what comes out of the capillaries? Plasma plus some WBCs. Plasma plus some WBC. It squeeze out. WBC has got the irregular shape. So WBC with some plasma, it comes out. And these are the cells which are present here nearby the capillaries. So this is called tissue. That's why first point I wrote is it keeps the body cells moist, because it squeeze out of the capillaries, because the flow of the blood is very slow when it moves in the capillaries, and in this way it keeps the cells moist. So this is how the first point can be justified. Then when some of the plasma and WBC has come out, it means it can maintain, we can say indirectly that lymph can maintain some of the volume of the blood. Okay, then it is responsible for the immunity, because lymph has got the WBC. WBCs are directly related with the immunity of the body. So we say that lymph is also responsible for immunity, or it enhances the immunity or maintains the immunity of the body. Second, last point is related with that it absorbs fat from the intestine. You know, the food is absorbed and digested in small intestine, and the very important component of food is fat, and fat is basically absorbed by the lymph capillaries, or you say indirectly lymph is responsible for the absorption of the fat portion of the food. Now this is the tabular difference between lymph and the blood. You can see the tabular difference between lymph and the blood. Lymph, it is colorless. It does not contain RBC, because I told you when lymph comes from the blood capillaries, that time it is plasma plus WBC. So no RBCs, and RBC, they contain hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a red color pigment and it gives red color to the blood, but RBCs are not present in lymph. It contains plasma, lesser number of WBC and platelets. It helps in body defense and a part of immune system. Basically, lymph means immune system, and its plasma lacks protein. Then blood, red colored because of RBC. Then it contains plasma, RBC, WBC, platelets. Everything is present as per the composition, and it is associated with circulation of oxygen and carbon dioxide, because I told you oxygen gets combined with the hemoglobin of RBC, and carbon dioxide, it moves in the plasma. It is dissolved in the plasma part. So this is how. Last is the plasma of blood. It contains protein and calcium. Thank you very much. Revise and practice.